An AEW star came close to appearing on WWE Raw last week, and is CM Punk lining up a return to WWE? But first, we have some very sad news as the son of a wrestling legend has passed away. In a statement released via Sean Ross Sapp of Fightful last night, it was revealed that Tristan Nash, the son of WWE Hall of Famer Kevin Nash, had sadly passed away at the age of just 26. The statement would be posted to Twitter, with a message being released from the Nash family, with it reading, "On behalf of Kevin and Tamara Nash, I have to unfortunately report that their son, Tristan Nash, has tragically passed away at the age of 26. Tristan recently started working on Kevin's new podcast, and the two enjoyed their time together. The Nash family asks if you could please respect their privacy during this time." As the statement notes, Tristan had begun working with his dad on the Click This podcast, with Tristan often being heard recently in the background, joking around with Kevin and co-host Sean Oliver. He was a musician, and had recently appeared on the podcast to promote an appearance at a music festival that he was set to perform at this coming weekend. As of this recording, no cause of death is currently known. No parent should ever have to go through this, and I send my condolences to both Kevin, Tamara, and the rest of Tristan's family and friends during this difficult time. And next, the president of New Japan is angry with WWE and one of their wrestlers. Last week on Monday Night Raw, Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, collectively known as the Good Brothers, would make their return to WWE, providing backup for AJ Styles in his heated feud with the Judgment Day faction. Both men are currently members of the Bullet Club in New Japan Pro-Wrestling, whilst Anderson is the reigning never openweight champion in the company, with the return catching many off guard, leaving their future in New Japan in doubt. Machine Gun and Big LG would recently provided an update via Twitter confirming that they are now double booked for November 5th, leading to the cancellation of Carl's title defense against Hikaleo at the Battle Autumn Show, with him instead heading to Saudi Arabia for the WWE Crown Jewel event. Speaking with Tokyo Sports Today, NJPW president Takami Obari would express his anger with the situation, although he declined to elaborate on Anderson choosing WWE over New Japan. The Good Brothers are said to be penciled in to appear for New Japan up until January 4th's Wrestle Kingdom 17 events, with there said to be a handshake agreement between both sides. However, they are officially now signed to WWE contracts, so that may now be void. Anderson has confirmed that he does plan on defending his belt at some point, with WWE even giving New Japan a heads up on the return, although it remains to be seen if they will be seeing out their agreement with the Japanese promotion due to the anger that it has caused. And next up, a top international champion is heading to the United States. This past weekend, AAA would hold their third and final installment of Triple Mania 30 from Mexico City, and the show would see AAA mega champion El Hijo del Vikingo successfully defending his title against Rey Fénix in a match that has been highly praised by those who witnessed it. Well, following his huge win at the event, it looks like Vikingo is set to cross the border to the United States for the first time in his career. Speaking with Sports Illustrated this week, Vikingo would reveal that he has now been granted a visa to work in the United States and said, "I first need to thank my home, AAA, and my friends from Masked Republic for making my dream of traveling to the United States possible. I know it is a great responsibility to head to a new country. It is a responsibility I will live up to and surpass. I want to thank all my fans for their unconditional support." With AAA set to run a show from the Mullet Arena in Arizona, the visa now allows the company's top champion to make the show. It also means he could appear for promotions linked to AAA via a working relationship, with them doing business with AEW, MLW, and Impact Wrestling in the past. And next up, an AEW star came close to appearing on WWE Raw last week. Last week on Monday Night Raw, the show would conclude with a D-Generation X 30-year celebration, with Triple H, Shawn Michaels, Road Dogg, and X-Pac all being present for the segment. One significant member of the group that was missing was Billy Gunn, who is of course signed to All Elite Wrestling. With that said, DX would address the elephant in the room, allowing the crowd to sing the badass Billy Gunn portion of Road Dogg's routine, before commentary made reference to Gunn's current run with the Acclaimed, joking that the other guy is doing something with office equipment these days, a reference to the Scissor Me Daddy catchphrase. Shortly after the episode was finished, a report would emerge from Fightful Select that said the idea of bringing Billy in was tossed around internally in WWE, although nothing ever materialized. With that said, the Wrestling Observer newsletter has now provided more details on the situation, noting that there were in fact talks between WWE and AEW over a one-off appearance from Billy Gunn. However, things fell through. through. It's said that AEW president Tony Khan specifically wanted WWE to mention the fact that Gunn is now in AEW, something WWE weren't willing to agree to. Fightful would then do a follow-up report to this, adding that WWE had organized travel in Billy Gunn's name with them thinking the appearance was a real possibility. They would add that AEW proposed that a lower third graphic would be shown on the screen with an AEW logo on display, again something WWE weren't willing to budge on. Whilst the appearance was ultimately nixed, it's interesting to know that negotiations even took place, showing both sides are still willing to work with each other under the right circumstances. However, this time the circumstances weren't quite right. And finally, is CM Punk lining up a return to WWE? Over the past few days, an All Elite Wrestling return for both The Elite and CM Punk has been speculated by fans, this fueled by references to both parties on this Tuesday's episode of AEW Dynamite. The show would see footage of CM Punk's Ring of Honor title win in 2005, the first time that he's been seen on AEW television since the backstage incident at AEW All Out 2022. The other side of the fight would also be directly referenced by commentary, who's spoke of The Elite being the inaugural AEW Trios champions, yet another first since the suspensions of Kenny Omega and the Young Bucks. On top of this, it appeared that the internal investigation into the matter was now complete, this fueled by reports of the AEW departure of Ace Steel, who played a significant role in the altercation. With that said, it seems that any hope of this real-life incident being turned into a storyline could now be over, as according to this week's Wrestling Observer newsletter, Punk and AEW are now in talks to end his contract early, with negotiations over a buyout ongoing. This, of course, leaves a potential return to Dynamite very much in doubt. And the report notes, AEW is in talks with Punk about the future, but right now it looks doubtful he will be back. Those with close knowledge of the situation said they are in talks with Punk about a buyout of the remaining years of his contract, which tells you that they are not looking to bring him back. If a buyout were to take place, this would be financially beneficial to AEW, as the cost of a buyout would be less than what they would pay him to see out the rest of his deal. The report notes that the key issue stopping the talks developing is the non-compete clause that would be in place were Punk to exit the company. The non-compete would see a period of time where he wouldn't be able to sign for another wrestling promotion. With Punk seemingly keen on a shorter non-compete than what is being proposed, this could suggest he is looking to stick around in the business, and the report notes, the holdup right now is said to be the non-compete period. Obviously, if the non-compete is an issue, it's about interest in going to WWE, because there's no need for a non-compete otherwise, because nobody else but AEW and WWE can pay him close to what he was making. Whilst WWE does have a troubled past with CM Punk, particularly with the current head of creative Triple H, a move to bring him back would be a huge coup for the promotion over their competition AEW, and would be even bigger than Cody Rhodes' switch earlier this year. Sean Ross Sapp of Fightful would then add to the CM Punk buyout talks, with him taking to Twitter to reveal that people in the company have always felt like this was the likely option, and he would tweet, there were suggestions from people close to AEW almost immediately following Brawl Out that CM Punk would eventually get a buyout. I don't know that it was in the works that far back, but a lot of people saw that as a likely scenario. What happens next remains to be seen, but it's worth noting that both Adam Pearce and Paul Heyman are close with Punk, and they do have some sway backstage in WWE, although right now no sources have confirmed if there has been talks over a possible return. Whether or not previous issues between WWE and Punk can be put aside to do business remains to be seen, but for now, CM Punk's future looks set to be outside of All Elite Wrestling. And before you go, make sure you check out 10 things you didn't know about AEW's Danhausen.